Okay, Edwin, this is going to be 30 minutes at 190 beats per minute cadence. I've got the core fast hand position in place, both hands, and I'm going to be doing this wringing technique. I'm going to be supinating, I'm going to be pronating, and I'm going to be doing it to fourth finger on that 45. I'll be doing a bunch of different variations throughout. This is follow along for the team. You gotta get this right. This full on extension like this and the full on pronation like this. Here we go. And 190. 90. Going for maximum range of motion at this cadence. That flexion lets me drive that arm up in the back. It's more tiring and fatiguing in the upper body and shoulders standing still than it is in actual running motion, but it's just this, boom, 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 getting that whipping, just like the big cats, just like a cheetah, just like a lion, just like a leopard, using that wrist with this fist to create that accelerant and that lift. The arm coming back is a lift. I like doing this to change the stimulus and to really emphasize the shoulder muscles to get that arm up. And then, however you're gonna choose to run with it, you get that little accelerant with that wringing action, that whipping action of the fist. Now here's a really fun one that I like, where I come up, balance. See the balance? Leg. Not even touching it down to the ground. You can do those variations as much as you like. Now the shoulders, if they get tired, you can change the angle so you're getting your back. Get this center line with that pronation. So I'm on like 45 degree angle to the center. So it's like this. Now this is that ring this way, like this. And you sort of come, the arms coming right here. In the beginning for me, my shoulders get real tired, but then 10 minutes in or so, I find that groove and I could go for 2 hours and my body won't be exhausted, but my upper body will develop that strength, endurance, and power of that range of motion. And I don't need to be tight in the fist. I just want to be notching with that thumb here, just notching and boom, 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 boom. It's that, boom, boom. So I'm getting a double down pulse, just like with propulsors, but I'm getting this ringing action that gives me that extra lift in the back. I think this is the key to it, is the height in training here, the height of the elbow in the back, because that's what gives me the lift and the carry through the air for a longer stride length with the same or faster stride frequency. We're going 190 beats per minute here, which is about 5 beats faster per minute than Eliud Kipchoge. Imagine if you can create a longer stride length and the same or faster stride frequency. Imagine what happens over 23,000 steps. Can we break a world record? Why not ask the question, and then why not go for it? You can come here low if you get tired, where you're really going after your traps up by the neck, up here. So you're getting that jolt, where you're getting that little bounce. I can come here where I'm really like pronating it here, where I've retracted my shoulders and I have a back and I'm just titmin' it right here. I can spiral a figure eight, where I come out here like this, and then come back to whatever is most comfortable. If you want to jog with it and just go back and forth to feel that timing and that integration, feel free. But because I have a bruise on the bottom of my foot, on the bone, I can't run right now. So this is how I'm conditioning, so that when my foot is better, I will have the upper body that gives me my pace and gives me that extra jolt. Just following along. The thumb is what notches that index finger in. The thumb just keeps it notched and you can relax it. And that's what it is. Afterward, I'll show you a little recovery exercise for the forearms. Because what you're developing here is you're developing the connective tissue, the tendons in the forearms. You're developing the tendons in the forearms to give them, to be able to express more power with less energy. So the tendons are developing. And so the wrists and the forearms can get a little bit of soreness from doing this. And I'll show you how to recover from that after, when we're done here. 190 beats. Okay. We're climbing up and approaching on that 10 minute mark pretty soon. That's a third of the way done with this half an hour, 30 minutes. How bad do you want it? How bad or how hard are you willing to work to get better, to run faster? It's that intent to roll it over. The intent to roll it over that gives me that up in the back, and then the intent to come here that makes the distance traveled inside the body further, because you're winding up the fascia, you're winding up those tendons, but the external motion is actually less distance in terms of what the hand is doing, where I get more vertical force with a greater accelerant and a jolt of power, because the hand is moving faster than the arm, significantly faster when I create that, boom, 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 boom. I'm extending and flexing. Working up a nice little sweat here. If it's hot where you are, then you get a little sweat. This is on this here. You change your postures. This is really getting the back of my shoulders and getting me that height. When I pitch it forward on this angle, down here, really emphasize the wrists. Trying to get up here, all the way up here. That. So I'm linking the connective tissue, linking that connective tissue that the muscles aren't working hard. It's the tendons and the fascia that's just giving me that bounce and that flight. You can even do this. Watch this. Where I'm putting in putting in little 1, 2, 3 at that faster cadence, sneaking those in if you want. Should have the team learn the technique. Make sure they're getting that. Make sure they're getting that. And then have them jog easy with it to feel that carry. And then have them run with it to see, does it help me or not? If it helps, it's worth doing. If it doesn't help, then it's not worth doing. Very simple. Very, very simple. You could even chant, sing songs, put little dance moves in. You can even put little, like you're running around a corner, get it up high, look at how high I'm getting, all the way there. So you're really working it, and then you come to the other side, really work it, and then you just come back here so you don't get the fatigue, because you're changing the angles, you're getting different development in the shoulder, and you're really giving your ability to get that range of motion. And when it comes time to pick up the pace, maybe pull away from the pack at some point, or catch up, whatever you need to do, you can just boom, boom, increase that amplitude of the travel of boom, boom, boom. How high up can you get that elbow and upper arm with ease because you're bending at the wrist? It's just like the cheetah does. It can lift its front paws and its front elbow much, much easier and faster because that's what it's doing. It's just doing it together and we're doing it one at a time. They're hitting the ground and we're not. Very similar in the biomechanics, however. I like this one where I'm coming here as opposed to here. Here would be this, where I'm coming here, and then here will be this, where I'm coming here. So you can change where you're targeting. I can change target on same shoulder. So this is coming across and this one's coming forward and back. Same shoulder, coming across, coming back, like this, like this. This is great for turns. If I need to turn, boom, I need to change that. I need to turn, change that. All right, we're about halfway through the workout. Should be just hitting your stride now where you're past the fatigue. Your shoulders aren't getting more tired. You just can keep this cadence, keep this range of motion. So if I just do regular, see how the range of motion isn't as far in terms of how high up I can get that arm. If I'm just doing regular, look at how high the arm comes. But when I do this, look at how high it comes, and I'm going at the same cadence. That's 190 with it, and that's 190 without it. Standing still, this feels easier. This is harder to do standing still, but if you can do this standing still, and have the endurance in the shoulders to do it for 30 minutes, to do it for 45 minutes, to do it for an hour, to do it for 2 hours. Well, now you can do it when you're running, because it's actually the work that you're doing in the upper body is gonna systemically throughout your body make it less energy. Because when you're running with it, you get the benefit of the ground reaction force making it so it's not your shoulders working as hard as just standing still. When I'm just standing still like this, my shoulders are working really hard. But again, if you could do this for 2 hours, well, can you run with it for 2 hours? What if you only needed 2 hours? What if it's not 2 hours, 10 minutes? What if it's not 2 hours, 11 minutes? What if it's 2 hours? Or what if it's less than 2 hours? What if? What if? What would it mean to run a legal race, not some set up with pacers and like an easy track, but a real legitimate marathon? Munich, to run the fastest legal marathon ever recorded in modern history. What if? What if? What if this gives you an advantage where physically and then psychologically, nobody's gonna catch me? Because they didn't learn the technique. They didn't put the work in. They don't know the form yet. They're just here. They're just here. They're using this and you're using this. What if? What if? See how I get higher on both ends here? Look at how high up the fist comes here. Look at how high up the elbow comes. So I'm getting more vertical displacement in the same amount of time, the same cadence, versus here where I'm not getting the same vertical displacement. There's less up and down here. There's more up and down here. All right, we're coming up on the 20-minute mark soon. Now it's easy. I'm at 20 minutes. I could do 2 hours now. There's no question. I'm only going to do 30, but I could definitely do this for 2 hours. Might get bored stiff. Maybe you should tell stories. Maybe you should sing songs. Who knows? Whatever helps you pass the time and keep the beat and the range of motion. Range of motion. You got wings that turn your body into springs, because you got the fist that allows the wrist to ring. Ring, 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 ring. Bop, 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 bop. Long. Now I'm going low. Low. So I'm getting up here. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, boom, boom. Long. If you get sore anywhere, just change the arrangement of it. Change how you're doing it. Right? So now you're getting a broad stimulus for different parts of your body. So when I come low like this here, and I get that, see, I'm getting maximum wrist. Now I'm getting all this connective tissue here. And then when I come up here, I'm getting more on the shoulders. Boom, boom. And I'm not tight. All I gotta do is notch it and then relax it. And then it's that. Not tight. Got a nice little sweat going in here because it's hot in here. And I can bounce. 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 Boom, 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 bounce. Boom. Boom, 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 boom. Vertical displacement. Boom, boom. Flight. Flight. Faster. Longer. Less global effort and energy. So what if, again, what if you could do 190? What if Eliud is doing, what if Eliud's doing 185 and only being here? And what if you're here doing 190? What if you outpace the Pacers? How bad do you want it? How bad do you want it? What are you willing to do? If you do the same things, well, you're gonna get the same result. If you do what's already known and practiced, well, then you're playing everybody else's game. But if you change, if you take that challenge to explore what might be faster, who knows? I don't know. The only one way to find out. And if the marathon's coming up in September, it's plenty of time. Plenty of time to put it in your body and make it your own. And now what if this is it? What if I'm running like this? What if every single step I'm doing that? Boom, 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 boom. What the heck is happening? How's he moving so fast? Look at that team, the Elgon Running Club. Look at that. Coming out of Kenya, baby. Come on, Kenya. They're doing something different at Elgon. They're doing something different at the Elgon Running Club. They're getting results that they never got before. They're changing the game. It's the same like the high jump. They used to do it some way, used to do it here. And what if now you do it here? What if? What if? It's fun to ask what if, because the reward can be huge. The reward can be sweet. I'm going to finish up in 30 minutes here, but if you want, keep it going and run the video again. Let's come back and get some more of these. So Good. Look at how high that arm's coming. Leg, 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 leg. With the balance, 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 balance. Boom, 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 boom. Get it all the way up. Elbow high, foot high. Boom, 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 boom. Flying, flying. Boom, boom, boom. Boom, 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 boom. Look at that. Range of motion. That actually makes it easier on my shoulders when I lift the leg, because the whole thing gives me lift. Boom, boom, boom. Woo! Hoo, hoo, hoo. Oh, hoo. Here it is. Yeah. All right. Got about 5 minutes left, somewhere thereabouts. Let's come down here. Let's get this. That range of motion. I got a nice sweat going. Make those wrists. Right there. Come back to here. See how high I'm going? That's it. How high I'm going. There you go. Look at that. That's where it's at. This is I think this may be my most significant and profound biomechanical discovery yet. This may be it. Get this side to side. There, 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 there. At 190. Look at how high up that arm comes. Look at how high up it comes. Running. 26.2 miles. 26.2 miles. There it is. 26.2 miles. Who's going to be the first to break 2 hours legally? Not artificially. Not when you got a laser beam and pacers all the way from mile 18 to mile 26, a car out in front of you, a track that's flat back and forth. Who's gonna do it on a real marathon course and set a real world record? Who's gonna do that first? Who's gonna be first? I don't think it's this person here. I don't think it's that person. I think it's that person. That's what I think. And I think this, based on what I can feel, I am fundamentally faster with this technique. And I just want to share it with anyone, especially the people who are physically much, 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 much better than me. Much, much better than me. I'm just finding the technique. I can't put it on the world stage. I need you guys. I need the Elgon team to make it known that you got an advantage now when you use technique. Technique. All right, so as we come in on the final minutes here, now I'm gonna start putting in even higher. Look how high I'm coming here. Bop, bop, bop. See how high I'm coming? Hoom, 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 hoom. What if at the end of the run? The end of the marathon. What if at the end your pace increases? What if? What if? Break the tape in less than two. Less than two. Break that 2 minute, or 2 hour, sorry. Break that 2 hour magical barrier. Used to been thought to not be possible. Eliud Kipchoge showed us that it is possible when you make the conditions apt absolutely perfect, right? And now, who's gonna be the first to do it legally? Legally, not illegally where it doesn't count as a world record. I'm talking about a world record recognized all over the world that it's a record, a world record. Who's gonna be the first? Who's gonna be the first? Look at that height. Boom, boom, boom. Look at that. It's the strength. It's the endurance. It's the power of technique. Using the tendons like human beings have never used them before. Why? Ooh, because we're doing it like the big cats. That's 30 minutes. Now, what can happen is in the morning, you can wake up and you're like, ooh, it's sore. What you do is you create a lot of friction up in the top here, here, massage the top where the muscles are, and then come back to this. So it's the ring, it's furthest you possibly can. This is a spiral that's going infinite, infinite, and that's a spiral that's going infinite following, thumb follows the fourth finger, and then the fourth finger reaches through like it keeps on going. It's this, right here. That was 30 minutes. Hope you followed along for all 30, and I hope you keep going to get 2 hours. God bless.